And if you want to see, one of the favorite tactics of leftists out there is to either make up a conversation with their children. They do this on Twitter. They'll say, my 9-year-old said that the Republicans' refusal to go along with the change in the filibuster. It's like, I'm pretty sure your 9-year-old did not say that, blue check writer for the Washington Post. But they also like to use children to make their political points. And here's an example of that. It's a 12-year-old reading a letter. This was put on CNN.
I would like to encourage the requirement of masks at school in Duval County. I'm so worried that if masks are not required, my brother could go to school one day and the next be dying in the hospital.
At school, I wear 2 masks because I want to make sure I don't get sick.
It's okay to have your own opinions. It's like you can think what you want to think, but also these masks have proven that they are saving people.
So I just want to be very clear here, Clay, because Democrats in the left, because they're shameless and have no principles, they love to use children as political landmines in a sense, right? They push them forward to carry the message. And when you start to criticize the message, they say, why are you criticizing the children? I mean, they did that with Greta Thunberg, if you remember.
Yes.
The 16-year-old who was, look, kids should not be used as political props in this way. The adults who do so are odious. CNN putting them on TV is appalling. I'm not criticizing children. I'm criticizing adults who think that I should give a what a 12-year-old thinks of mask policy, Clay. But you're actually dealing with mask policy when it comes to kids right now.
Yeah, those were kids, by the way, Jacksonville, Florida, where Ron DeSantis and kids going back. My kids return to school tomorrow. So I have a first grader and I have a fifth grader, 2 elementary school kids. Well, I know some of you out there are like, what, you're checking your phones right now? You're like, wait a minute, it's going to be August 6th. Yeah, we start early in many different parts of the South. We get out early. They got out in May, early May, relatively speaking. And my kids are going back and I'll be walking them to school tomorrow. And I'm genuinely curious to see. There's no mask mandate in the public school where my kids are going. But in Nashville, which is where I live, a little bit north of where we are now, they do have mask mandates at some schools. And so I know there are a lot of parents out there right now. And you, I've hinted at this before, Buck, because I think it's going to turn into a monster battle to see what parents. Because last year, a lot of parents, I'll put myself in this category, Buck, we were just excited to have our kids in school. And so they had to wear masks, but it was like all, they got out in March, it had been months.
We've talked about it, yeah. Lululemon already. Can I just, Clay, I worry. I've been so disappointed at how much most of America
just
has
accept.
Been willing to go along with here. And I'm with you in that I want to see angry moms out there, but I think a lot of them, even in places, they're just going to say, oh, it's just a mask. This is what ends up. It's just this thing. I don't know if people are angry enough over this. They're much angrier about vaccine mandates than they are mask mandates.
Yeah, but I think there's something about the kids because we know the data. And I think we're going to talk, by the way, to Alex Berenson in the third hour. He's going to be in studio with us here in New York. And I'm excited to talk with him about this. But the data is all so clear. That kids, you know, despite what that 12-year-old saying that CNN was falling in love with.
Isn't that appalling, though, by the way? Can we just for a second, like CNN puts 12-year-olds making the case that they want made on TV? What are we supposed to do with that? How about a 5-year-old, CNN? Do you want to have a kid that can't even read and write yet telling us what should happen with the? But you know what the answer is? You and I right now, there are people that probably, you know, Media Matters, whatever. Clay Travis and Buck Sexton trashing children over mask mandates. That's what they love to do.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that headline will exist somewhere. But I do think that there are, because again, last year it was like, hey, I just want my kids to be in school. This year, I want my kids to be in school and I want everything to be 100% normal. I mean, because that's what the science tells me should be the case. Teachers, if you're terrified, get the vaccine. Kids are not primary spreaders. The virus never has spread abundantly through kids. That's one of the good things about the data that it tells us about COVID since last year. And we know that teachers aren't under particular risk, but I think there are a lot of parents like me who are going to be taking their kids to school in the next few days, and I'm going to be doing it tomorrow, that are genuinely curious to see, does it feel normal again, or are we still kind of under the scope and the ambit and the control of this mask policing nonsense.